You can call it Apple, Nvidia, USDT, you can call it BTC, you can call it apples. It's the same logic. How do you buy? Do you buy aggressively? Do you buy conservatively? All these moving averages are, it gives me an insight into, is this an uptrend? Is this a downtrend? Is this a sideways market? Let's solve this once and for all. Today's whole topic that we want to talk about, and I really want to get through to you guys, is a lot of you guys, your eyes go onto the moving averages. It's actually not as hard as you think, but it's not as simple as you think. It's because we're not looking at it from a single viewpoint. We're looking at it from a multi-viewpoint, and I'm going to explain that today. Let's start with the idea of why MAs. Okay, why MAs? When I look at MAs, I don't use the MAs to make a trading decision in terms of entry and exit. Not like that. Okay, so it's not like, okay, prices have come back down to my MA and it's reversing back from the MA. Hit the buy. Okay, not like that. Not like that. Not like that. So I want to make that very, very clear for you guys. That's not what I'm doing. Okay, is that clear? Right? Let's talk about why MAs are important. So what is MAs? If we open up that word, MAs, it represents moving averages, right? Moving averages. What that means is, let's say, I'm going to give you the parameters of my moving averages. So the one that's super close to the price, that's 20. Okay, 20 EMA. Okay, the one that's a little bit further away is the 50 EMA. Okay, and the one that's furthest, which is down here, is the 200 EMA. When we're looking at moving averages, the whole idea is, if you set the moving average, these are EMAs, exponential moving averages. So let me show you the settings of this. Okay, here's the setting. So input, you can see the length is set to 20. The source is set to close. What that basically means is, whatever time frame you choose, your 20 EMA will give you an average of the last 20 candles. Okay, so if your EMA here is the last 20 from there, your EMA here is the last 20 from there. Does that make sense? Okay, now the one about 50, therefore the one that's 50, it means the last 50 candles from that moment. The 200, the last 200 candles from that moment. Okay, so what this essentially does, it gives me an insight into the trend. Okay, all these moving averages are, it gives me an insight into the trend. Now, why trend? If we say prices are starting to go from here, they're starting to go higher, I'm aware that the larger player has a demand saying, I really want this, and I'm willing to pay more. That means there's no sellers and there's so much buyers. Okay? Okay, whatever the sell that was being offered, the buyer says, I'm willing to pay more. Whatever you gave me. If you give me 2 and I buy 4, does that work? Does that equal out? Think of that logic. If you give me 2 and I want 2, then the net is 0, right? You're giving me 2, I want 2, the net is 0, price will not move. You're giving me 2, I want 60. Now, you'll say, I don't have it. The other guy might say, I have 2, but I'm not giving you it for this price. I'm giving it to you for $10 more expensive. Someone else will come in and say, you know what? Forget that Navin guy. I'll pay you 20. Give it to me. The next guy comes in, forget that. You have 2, right? I'll buy it from you. Give it to me at $50 a piece. That's how the price rises. You understand that? It's a game of give it to me, give it to me, give it to me. But if you understand that game, then you understand a movement like this is a sign that the larger player still wants it, still being the keyword, still wants it. Okay? Okay, if he still wants it because he didn't get enough, okay, he's not filled. He didn't get enough. He wants more, but he's not getting his hands on it because no one has it. This tells me that if I'm on my 60 minutes, it tells me the demand of the larger player is still interested. They're still willing to buy whatever discounts come in. This tells me from a higher time frame, the big dogs, they're still interested, whatever comes in. Now, how many of you guys look at this and say, you know, well, if we come below the MAs like that, shouldn't we be selling? Well, that's a very simpleton way to think, and that's a very logical way to think, but it's a very simplistic way. You have to think about it this way, is if it's selling, there is a larger player looking at this and saying, oh, discount, discount, come, 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 give me, give me, give me. You understand what I'm saying? So what happens is by having these multiple timeframes, I'm not looking to trade using the multiple timeframes. It gives me a visual understanding of saying, what's going on? Who wants this? And if this time frame no longer wants this because it's falling through the MAs, but I see an inclined MA from the higher time frame, it gives me an idea of saying, I don't think the sell will last long. It can't. Because it's going to be swooped up. It's going to get bought. So I position myself accordingly. Does that make sense? Is it making sense? Is it clicking? Now, if I'm on the 1 hour, okay, let's do a little bit of fun stuff for you. If I'm on the 1 hour, from 1 hour to 4 hour, how many candles is that? How many multiples is that? Four times, right? From 1 hour to 4 hour is four times. So if you have a 20 EMA, you multiply that by four times is what? 60? It's very close to this line. So I know what the 4 hour is doing and how they're trending without going to the 4 hour manually. If I'm on the 4 hours and I do that same multiple for the daily, I can know what the daily is thinking without actually going to the daily. So this tells me just by looking at this screen, I know what my time frame is trying to do and I know what larger players are trying to do. Does that make sense? This tells me what kind of demand is there in the market for this product. What kind of demand is there in the market for this product? When I use the word product, I always want you to think it's not New Zealand yen. Change that to anything. You can call it Apple, Nvidia. You can call it USDT. You can call it BTC. You can call it apples, oranges. It's the same logic. Price goes up because someone wants it. How price goes up tells you how much someone wants it. Does that make sense? So many of you guys, if you guys look at this and say, oh, look, there is a higher high. Higher high, higher low means uptrend. How many of you guys know that information? Simple. Higher high, higher low, right? Okay. Here's a higher high, higher low. Okay. This one. Here's the next one. Higher high, higher low. Here's the next one, higher high, higher low in progress. Now, you see all of these things, right? Just like the next guy, but I want you to take the details out of this. When you have the higher high, how long does it take to make that higher high? That's 8 hours long or more, right? I didn't count the candles, but I'm assuming 8 hours. How long did it take this time? Oh. 5 hours. How long did it take this time to make a higher high? Oh, 3 hours. You got to observe these things. The faster prices rise, the more immediacy they're looking. Just because it makes a new high doesn't mean anything on its own. It's a new high, and the speed and the time it took to do that, that gives you information. That gives you actionable information that you can say, that means something. Now, I'm going to explain this in a way where it's not chart basis, where you can actually relate to it and be like, ah, got it. Okay, now take a look at this. Okay, here we go. Now, if you want to buy, I don't know, I always do this. If you want to buy this pen, okay, if you want to buy this pen, and the price right now is $1, okay, that's the highest point is $1, and the price drops to 50 cents. Okay, now, if all of you guys in this room start fighting for this pen, because I only have one, and some of you guys are like, you know what? I'll give you 60 cents. Some says, you know what? Forget that guy. I'll give you 62 cents. You know what? I'll give you 62.5. You know what? I'll give you 70. You know what? I'll give you 71 cents. Tell me the speed that it's going up. Tell me the speed you notice, the intensity of the buy. Not so strong, right? Perhaps this pen is not of desire. Let me switch it up right now and ask you guys this thing. From all of you guys fighting, you see interest in this pen and you say, I'll give you 70 cents. The next guy says, I'll give you $1.45. Both situations that I just drew, they're making a higher high, but the intensity of this one, you can feel how quickly the price went as a higher high. That means there's a lot of people here that want this again. If you can get one more of these, they're going to run over each other to get it. Do you understand? Just because it's a higher high, it's not just the simplistic, oh, higher high means uptrend, therefore I must buy. How do you buy? Do you buy aggressively? Do you buy conservatively? It paints a picture. It prepares you in a different style each time. Let's take a look at something a little bit more complex, okay? So far, so good. We talked about the easy stuff. This is all one directional. How easy is that, right? Here's the part where it gets difficult for many people. Is this an uptrend? Is this a downtrend? Is this a sideways market? Let's solve this once and for all, because many of you guys always have this question of, well, Navin, how many candles exactly should I look far back? Because according to this, we're in a range. According to this, we're in a downtrend. But according to this, we're in an uptrend. My head is going to explode. Which one is it? How many of you guys in here suffer from that? You know, when I see this, I get confused. It's a very common thing to experience. It's a very common thing to experience. And let's fix that today, once and for all. Shall we do that? Let's fix this once and for all. Why I have multiple MAs is to sort of give me the guiding eye. Give me the guiding eye. Ready? If you have a movement that goes up, green, 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 green. I'm always interested in, did we break into a new high? And if I see yes, we broke into a new high, from this was the highest point, and now we broke into a new high, I look for who's the guy who started that movement, and I would come down and say, oh, it started here. This is the guy who started it. Okay? If we say we're going down, but did we break this lowest point? No. We're going down. Did we break this low? No. Still buyer's market. We're going down. Did we break this low? No. Still buyer's market. And then when it does this, it goes pow. And now we're on poking our heads out onto the other side. Who's the guy who started it? Then we say there. Anyone who can make a lower low or a higher high becomes person of interest. Put it that way. Now, if we see that situation, right? And they're hitting a down right here. And then it stops. It stops right there. When this thing goes up, is it a buy? No. Did we take out the guy who started it? No. And it comes down. Is it selling again? No. Did we take out the guy on the bottom? No. And it goes up. Did we take out the guy? No, it's not a buyer. And then it comes down, makes a new low. New low. Who made that new low? It started here. The engine started here. Here. So that's where our anchor becomes. We're like, we're glued to that. We're like, I see you, big man. I see what you've done. Does that make sense? The guy who started it in a simplistic way, did this make sense to you guys? Now keep this stuff in mind, what I just explained. Keep that thing in mind. Whenever price is moving in a particular direction and prices begin to crash and I see the price on the other side of the MAs, it goes on the other side of the 20. It goes on the other side of the 50. Why is it going down? Is it a selling market? Is it a selling market? Am I supposed to sell? Okay, watch this very carefully. Do not take your eyes off of this. Ready? The same time, I'm also aware from a larger view, the 200 candles, which means from a larger timeframes perspective, they're still in an uptrend. Which means whatever that down is, they're like, meh, we'll buy it. Let it come. Now, does that mean if it touches it, I should buy it? No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. It gives me a sense of investigate. Take a look at this market. It's upwards. The MAs seem to hold balance. 20, 50, they're holding balance. I'm not using it to trade. I want to remind you of that. So don't get into it like, Navin told me the secret. 20 MA, 50 MA, 200 MA. Now I'm rich, baby. Don't lose balance. Stay calm. Okay. Highest point in the sky. Who's the guy who started it? Who made that buy? This fella. Are we in a seller's market? No. Are we in a seller's? No. Are we in a seller's? No. Are we in a seller's? Yes. Stand by. We have now approached a seller's market. Stand by. Do not touch this trade. Stand by. But the flow maintains. Remember the angle up. And then suddenly, guy who started it's here. What happened? A buyer shows up full caliber right in front of their face. The market switched back. So anyone from a smaller time frame who was looking at this saying, am I supposed to sell? You can't. You can't sell. If you sell, you're playing with fire because what's the thing you said in the beginning of the webinar? You know that the game is played by the larger players, the big boys. If the big boy is clearly telling you, I want to buy, why are you trying to be his victim by trying to sell? Don't sell. You now have a sense of understanding of whatever that mess I saw on the daily, buyer's market. Buyer's market. And it's nothing else but buyer's market. I need to put my focus in buy patterns. Whatever your pattern is, if you're a pattern junkie, stay by pattern. Your odds of you winning increase when you have the big boy saying, let's go, kid. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. I'm going that way. You want to come? It's this way. If you go against me, I'll chop your head off. MAs are useful. They can be a guide. Now, are MAs things to enter? No, they're not tools for you to use to enter. That's why indicator for me still is no. Because when people say, Navin, do you use indicators? I already imagine they're saying, how are you using indicators to enter the market? All right, wonderful gentlemen. I hope you guys had a wonderful time. Those of you guys who are in the course, things are going to get a little bit more intense over there. Those of you guys who are not part of Urban Forex, I urge you to look into Urban Forex and see what we have to offer. It will change the way you trade. So I'm going to leave you guys to it. Thank you so much for coming in. As always, this is fun. It's been wonderful to hang out with you guys. Thank you. Thank you guys. Until next time. Cheers. Bye for now.